This is not an ordinary bar of chocolate. This is a creamy, dreamy paperback bar of chocolate. This is not an ordinary carrot. This is a particularly orangey, crunchy, day-fresh carrot. This is not an ordinary Rolo square. This is a gooey, yummy BLM bakery Rolo square.
There is a very well-known supermarket who has adverts on television which always say that their food is not just good, it is the very best. In today's story, John, the writer of the Gospel, is wanting us to know that Jesus is not just good. He is the very best. And in chapter 3, he tells us the story about a man named Nicodemus. And Nicodemus was a ruler. He was a ruler in the community. He was a ruler in the synagogue. He was a teacher. He knew a lot about the Bible. He knew a lot about religion. He was very well respected. And he came to speak to Jesus at night. He came perhaps because he knew that other people would wonder what he was doing. But he came because he was interested and he wanted to speak to Jesus. So he arrived to talk to Jesus in the dark of the night. And he said to Jesus, "We know that you are a good teacher sent to us from God." Jesus interrupted him and he said something very strange. He said, "Nicodemus, you must be born again." Nicodemus did not understand what Jesus was saying at all. But Jesus was saying, "Good, you know that I am a teacher sent from God, but I have something much better for you. I have the very best for you, Nicodemus. You need to be born again. You need new life. I don't just want you to know things about me, Nicodemus. I want you to have new life. I want to give you absolutely wonderful life. I want to give you the very best." Jesus wanted not just life for now for Nicodemus. He wanted life forever for Nicodemus. He wanted joy in heaven for Nicodemus. And then Nicodemus said to Jesus, "I don't get that. How could I go back into my mum's tummy and be born again? It just doesn't make sense." And Jesus said to him, "Nicodemus, you need to be born again by the water and by the Spirit." What Jesus was really saying was this: "Nicodemus, it's good to have your sins washed away." And the picture that he used was water. "But I have something better for you. I have the very best in store for you. I want you to be born again in the Spirit. I want the Holy Spirit to come and live inside you." He wanted Nicodemus not just to be forgiven for his sin, which is great and wonderful, but he wanted the Holy Spirit to come and live inside Nicodemus so that Nicodemus could go on to live for Jesus and have the power to live for Jesus. He wanted the very best for Nicodemus. But this conversation was not going well for Nicodemus. He just did not understand. And he looked at Jesus and he just said, How can this be? And Jesus said, Wow, you're a teacher, but you still don't understand. And what Jesus was saying was this. It's good, Nicodemus, to know all sorts of things. It's good to know about the Bible. It's good to know about doing good works. It's good to know about going to church. It's good, all those things. But I have something much better for you. I want the very best for you. And Jesus said, if you believe in the Son of Man, in Jesus himself, if you believe in me, you will have eternal life. Not just life right now, but life forever. Jesus was saying, you can have religion and that's okay. You can have knowledge and that is good. But I want something better for you, Nicodemus. I want the very best. I want you to believe in me. I want you to have a relationship with me. I want to be friends with you. I want to live every day with you, Nicodemus. I want to live every day now with you, Nicodemus, and I want to live every day in eternity in heaven after you die with you, Nicodemus. Because Jesus didn't just want what was good for Nicodemus. He wanted what was better and what was the very best. And Jesus wants to give you not just what is good, but what is better, what is the very best. He wants your life not just to be good. He wants it to be better. He wants to be giving you the very best life. He wants the very best for you because he loves you so very, very much.